This is the far southern stairs, so maybe these guys. I must have missed something. Oh, I see there's a door that I missed. In here. Turn. There we go. How the fuck? Bean. Where is your brain, man? You ain't even been drinking. The game hasn't forced you into drinking yet. Oh, see, like, yeah, there's this whole other area that I just never fucking explored because video games. Oh, you can use the dino poop. Okay. It's dark. You're likely to be eaten by a Gru. I'm honestly surprised it took anybody that long to make a Zork reference. I'm not angry. I'm just disappointed. Poil, you get like 1/256th of a VIP for that. Keep track, because I won't. Haven't played Zork in like 20 years. Yeah, I feel you on that one. Zork was, I've never been big on adventure games. So Zork was, is something that I have a cursory familiarity with, but I've not played any of them to completion. My wife loves the older ones, but. You did Dragon Quest, all that? Dragon Quest? No. Really? Wow. Huh. I actually really liked the first Dragon Quest Builders. I never played the second one, though. Right, a Let's Play. I mean, that's, when it comes to, like, adventure games like that, the old ones, like, just reading a playthrough is as good. Because it's not like the games have a ton of, like, different paths and stuff you can go through in them. Yeah, like the old school text adventures like that, those missed me. Like when it came to adventure games, I will play like a graphical adventure game, even going back to like the old parser based ones. But like the purely text based ones, it doesn't do anything for me. I got all my text based gaming out of me when I was playing like Batmud back on fucking AOL. And see, there you go. Celt's got it. I guess that's basically how I look at it. What do we got? Two A's, all right. Poison dagger. No, that's only one A. You guys, how does the letter A work? Probably phantasmal hand. Phantasmal hand has three A's though. But I assume that's still, oh, it is a phantasmal hand, you son of a bitch. God damn it, Chunk. Phantasmal hand appears. Bitch slaps Rove so hard his neck just spins around. He drops dead. As Ela just sits there licking his chops. Not hearing my voice, really. Is anybody else not hearing my voice? I'm not dead yet. Fine for you, I can hear. Okay. In that case, it's on your end, Moody. I was gonna say, like, yeah, OBS looks okay. Very strange. Piss. Alright. What do we got, Chunk? Keep telling yourself it was a real spell. It's actually just a mage hand cantrip. 5 pounds of force turned Rove into a corpse. Probably poison dagger. Or it could also be prismatic missile. I'm gonna hope that it's prismatic missile. Oh, got it. A lance, a cutlass, leather boots. How did you get a lance in there, man? How do you, video games. Is a lance even worth anything? I assume it's a polearm. Valkyrie only, wow. How much is it worth? 450? Not even gonna bother. I might take the leather boots though and give those to Ela. The healing potions. What does this do? Heal wounds at a power level of 1. I'm gonna go ahead and probably pass on all of that stuff. It's not worth hauling around. Don't you need to be mounted to use a lance? No. At the end of the day, it's still a long pointy stick. It's just more effective if you're mounted. It's a cat horse in a row. We don't have a cat horse, we just have Ela. He's not good enough to be the cat horse. He's just the cat. The worst part. Yeah, and Ela isn't carrying shit. Ela just needs fucking armor. Ela really, there is low level samurai armor in this game. They just don't start the samurai with it, and I'll be asked if I know where to actually find the stuff. He's just yes, Ela is the food carrier. Man, I wish we had Ravenloft style lightning bolts in this. I don't think there are any offensive spells that hit like all groups of enemies. Well, I take that back. I think there's one spell that hits all group of enemies. I think Nuclear Blast will melt a group. Let me check. Nuclear Blast. Yeah, Nuclear Blast hits all enemies. Actually, so does Deadly Air. So there are a couple, like, all-enemy AoE spells, but to get those, he needs a casting stat in, like, the 90s, I think. Yeah, Armageddon. Good old Tilt-A-Weight. We are a ways away from that, if I had to guess. What is Rove's? Academia. Thaumaturgy of 65. He needs a 98 to cast 7th level spells. Yeah, after a couple turns as a wizard, we'll get there, but it's gonna be a bit. Deadly Air. I think it's described as a spell that, like, is more or less, yes, Cloud Kill. Okay, back here. Is this another? No, another room with a chest. All right. I assume these are minor dwarves. We'll just melee through them. Burning Hands in Ravenloft is... Burning Hands in Ravenloft is... nuts. I think the reason it's so good is that they don't have a cap on the bonus damage from your caster level. So since Rove's like 13th level, it's doing a d4 plus 13, which makes it way better than it has any right to be, given that it hits everything. Oh, these are major dwarves. Hey guys, magic missile. Just another 10 on a DC 10 check to avoid a lawsuit. Yeah, they're not the only ones doing it, though. I want to say Deadly Air was a spell in Black Crypt, too. All right, what do we got? Inspect chunk. Okay, nothing. Disarm? Cloud of Fear. I mean, we got the right trap, but he failed to disarm it. Fauchard, dagger, cloth pants, knock knock, scroll. What are these fucking chests, man? I don't care about any of that. Hey, yo, guys, you want some pants? No. No, go home. Take your pants and go home, you fucking weird fauchard holding motherfucker. Oh my god. Vorpal Aaron Black Crypt, there we go. But nobody played it. Yeah, we only played the good dungeon crawlers here. Issue with your sound, okay. Glad to hear it, Moody. No pants for the party, this is a pantsless zone. I'm pretty sure everybody already has pants, except for Ela, and maybe Rove, and maybe Goldleaf. But none of them matter, so we're good. Oh, Goldleaf's awake now. Oh, they're shrieking. Thankfully the AoE, the AoE doesn't wake people up. That's less than ideal. Oof. I'm glad it only hits the front four and that Scimitar is slowly... Oh no, it did wake him up. And Scimitar is slowly getting a little beefier with levels. Everyone get pants except half the party. Yes, exactly! I mean, half the party... Well... Two-thirds of the... A third of the party is female, so... I love the mental imagery. He's wearing like a leather hauberk and his ass is just hanging out. No, he's got like, I think, a robe bottom on. Yeah, a third of the party is wearing dresses, gold leaf and robe. The ladies of the party, the two elves. Yeah, I think Ela, yeah, he's got robes on his lower half. Gold leaf has robes, and I think Rove does as well, yes. Basically like, yeah, basically kind of like a kilt, like a long kilt type of thing, I assume. It's like how in Dungeon Master, like a robe takes up your top and your bottom half for reasons, instead of just being like an armor slot, because they want both. They want both like a torso armor slot and a legs armor slot. I want Swell to do the healing just to conserve mana on Old Leaf. Man, I should play Daggerfall again. One more nap. No shirt, no shoes, no service. I never said anything about pants. Yeah, Morrowind is like top shelf when it comes to like piecemeal gear. And I agree, I really like that style of that level of being able to customize your gear for multiple reasons. Not the least of which is being able to get like really just cool equipment set appearance combinations going. Instead of Daggerfall, you should play Battle Spire. I've never actually played Battle Spire. It looks like an adventure. Preferably 8 characters. Like an 8 character party. I mean, if you want that, go play Grimoire. That's an 8 character party. Although I think 2 of them have to be hirelings, which to my understanding are just like better than other characters. I don't know. I should play Redguard. Ugh, no, it's an adventure game. I am not a fan of adventure games at all. I'm playing ESO, it's unique. ESO is a fun game to poke around in, but the combat just bores me to like high heavens, so I just can't. But it's a fun game to co-op. I'm surprised you're not playing Guild Wars. Don't they have like some big new expansion coming out for it? I remember you being pretty deep into that. My wife actually played the shit out of Elder Scrolls Online. Like, holy shit. She put like hundreds of hours into that game over a couple months. Last year, I think. Had a real good time playing it with one of her friends. Go ahead and just energy blast this dude. Yes. That is basically it. Yeah, ESO is like if you want to just shut the brain off, it's a good time. But yes, co-op and MMO. Haven't bothered you. Lost interest in Guild Wars, sir. What have you done with the Jamalus who used to try to get me back into that game all the time, forever and always? With his fancy raptor mounts and shit. I do not want your heavy boulder game. One step, and we get some dwarves. Rove. Stink bomb them. Rove throwing jars of Ela's secretions at them. Man, Realms of the Haunting was such a good game. It's like, I want to play it again, but there's really no point in playing again because it's a freaking adventure game. But man, Realms of the Haunting, that game is better than it had any right to be. Holy crap. Chelsea knows, not an introvert, not an extrovert, an ambivert, most likely any. Never change, Jim. Never change. Chunk beating the shit out of clouds. Ela also beating the shit out of Clouds. I mean, I gotta say the party feels pretty powerful at this point. Like, we're not really having too much trouble. There, every so often we get into fights where we kind of have to, like, pay attention, but by and large, I'm gonna say, oh my god. See, of course, I'm running my mouth and the game's like, here's two mountain giants and two floaters. Get fucked, you. I'm gonna cast Weaken as powerful as we can on those mountain giants. Gold Leaf, Bless, Rove, Magic Missile the Clouds, and hopefully just kill them off. I don't think the Clouds really can do much, but dropped an expansion with new elites, dropped another one this month. Oh, wow. Fair enough. Have to give me a shout out from the YouTube uploads in 20. Oh, Ultima Underworld, man, I had a good time playing those. I'm glad they helped you through the lockdown. Like, that was, I got a lot of messages from people echoing that during peak COVID, and it makes me happy to hear, because, like, it means I'm, like, doing my job essentially. Floater cast prismatic missile. Oh no! Scimitar turns to stone. See, and this is why. This is why floater's bad. Just insta-gibbed. That's a reload right there. Painful. Well, I'm sorry to hear that you kind of fell off the Guild Wars train. I mean, I guess you got your time out of it. Maybe go back later once things are a little bit more to your liking. I get it. Been there before. Rove, Wago, please. No, Rove. Wago, please. Thank you, sir. As he nukes half my party with a fireball. Good god. Ah, fireball's doing work. Back an inch if you're legendary. Yeah. Well, I mean, that's their thing, is like, they still, like, the level cap's still the same as it's always been. And I know they, like, build stuff mostly so that, like, even the toppest tier stuff is, like, side grades and shit. Which I actually think is, like, brave as hell of them, because most people get dragged back into, like, expansion packs because, oh, I gotta have the highest numbers on my equipment. Oh my god. Giants Tricksters, I remember being kind of nasty. Ela, make them afraid. Chunk, murder them. Scimitar, weaken on those giants. Gold Leaf, I guess haste the party. And Rove, I want you to magic missile those Tricksters. I think Tricksters can, like, blind you and shit. I agree with you on that, Celt. I would much rather a game go with side grades than always just, like, you gotta get the biggest numbers. I think it makes things much more interesting. Oh, these things are doing damage. I bet you these guys are mountain giants. Oh, they're hill giants. All right. Not expecting that, given the damage output. Sin, Angel's Tongue, Gold Leaf, how about a good heal, Rove, Fireball. Ooh, Ela just dumpstered one of them. Little crits going off. That's the thing that I like about the crits in this, is that, like, they're rare enough, but, like, next to nothing is immune to them. 2,000 XP, not bad. I actually want to check, how's Rove's kills? 327, Ela with 181, 199, 66. I think Scimitar, since the last time I checked, I think he's gained either three or six. I think the last time we looked, he was at like 23 or 26 kills. He doesn't kill anything. Poor Scimitar. Hill'jaenas just got lucky with RNG a little bit. Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good, I suppose. We have found a corner. Let's have a nap. The hill they're coming from is just 20 meters shy of being a mountain. Odd. Ow. Oh, this is it right here. Okay. This is what I was looking for. The remains of a large wooden machine are resting upon the precipice. After looking it over, you decide it is for hurling heavy objects through the air, much like a catapult. On the opposite side of the precipice, you see a tiny ringed target standing all by itself. Okay. Inspecting the machine, it appears to be operational except for a sprocket, which is cracked and fallen out, and a long band of rubber, which has lost its spring and begun to crumble. We found a broken sprocket. All right, we have to take this to Smitty to get it repaired. So we are going to go do that. I smash my party's faces into a wall. All right. Easy way to get to Smitty. Not through here. That's a lot of slimes. This might be a bad time. Roll yourself through the air. No. We've learned how hurling myself through the air works. Is not the solution to this problem. God, I can't believe it's already going on 5:30. I gotta say that, like, when I was running Kingmaker, that time dragged, and with this, the time is friggin' flying. Come on, no poison. Alright, what do we got? An acid slime. Poison slimes. Three of them is conveniently AoE enough for magic missile. Kill them all. One, two, three. Hell yeah. Good job, Rove. Wow, Ela, doing those ones for damage, man. Very impressive. I guess at least you're hitting. I would expect at least that, given that you have a 100 skill with your sword. Now we're in the dark area. Oh, we can swing by the mana fountain while we're here and top everybody off. Yeah, the movement drags in the dark areas because it, like, every time it has to tell you that it's dark at the bottom of the screen, like, the game hitches. Oh, this is healing us too. Holy shit. This is just like the Uber fountain. It does everything. Health, mana, and stamina. God damn. Yeah, this is like a really good place for grinding then. It's just a shame we can't, like, bump into things like mountain giants down here. So I would fight the hell out of those things. No. Turn around. This is very close to the Uber fountain. I'm certainly not complaining. Is it here? No. It's this one? Yes. Alright. Alright, Smitty. Dang nabbit, can't you see I'm busy? Goldleaf is gonna talk to you. Sprocket. I'd have to take a look at one first. Alright, well. So I think what we want to do is trade. Give. Broken sprocket. It's busted, all right. Doesn't look too bad. It'll cost you 1,000 golds. Yes. He takes it and begins whistling. Bang, bang, clang, clang, bang, bang. Whoosh. Only be a few minutes. More video game noises that aren't video game noises. Good as new. All right. Sprocket acquired. Now we gotta walk all the way back. And if you think this is a bad bit of, like, getting a thing and then having to go back, just wait. Wait until we find the caterpillar. Come on, guys. I was gonna say, you better be able to kill that freaking thing. 1,000 XP. I'll take it. It's this guy, and then it's this guy, and then all the way around. Mark and recall. Yeah, no fucking kidding. Now, this is the era where if they gave us a teleport spell, it would be like, cast teleport, and it's like, how many squares forward do you want to go? And you pray you don't end up, like, teleporting your party into rocks and just, like, completely gibbing yourself. Sounds like Wizardry 1, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I know that there were some parts in Wizardry 1 that, like, if you teleported into them, you couldn't get out unless you could, like, had more casts of teleport, and, like, you could permanently lose characters there and stuff. All right, it needs a new rubber band, and it needs a new sprocket. So how do I have to use them, maybe? Rubber band? The new rubber band fits perfectly. All right. Sprocket. The replaced sprocket gently nestles into place on the old machine. Having repaired the catapult, you may now perform normal firing operations. All right, I am going to abort fire, and I'm going to save, because I don't recall whether or not, like, you can fail at this. Okay. Wind up the band, or do we have to latch the ladle? Wind up the band. Okay. Gonna save. Use gold leaf. Wait, no, I think Rove. I think I gave the rock to Rove, didn't I? Yeah. You load the big stone into the ladle of the catapult. Okay. Abort fire for now. Save. Feasting on a baked pan-sized chocolate banana cookie. Aw, man. That sounds delicious. Okay. Lash the ladle. Wind up the band. Release it. Bullseye! And now we have progression. I know we're nearing the part where we're gonna have to deal with the Amazulus, and it's gonna be a pain in the ass. But it'll be another merchant. I think she sells spells too. Oh, hey, more mountains to climb. Let's not. I'm going to have to though. Climb here. Okay. Grand Target or Walmart. Ah. Oh. The big box store puns. Come on. Hey. Okay. Uh-oh. What do we got? Oh, two floaters. Alright, all we can do is attack and pray. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. That's one. Get the other one. Kill it. Kill it. Oh, thank Christ. 2,000 experience points. How are we looking? 150,000. We're actually nearing another level for everybody. It's gonna be like 160 is gonna be. I've been waddling around, confused and lost, long enough to gain almost as many experience points as I've gotten in the last two streams. Good God. Damn it. You guys. Climb. Thank you. There's a small foothold which leads down. No. Save. Small foothold which may be climbed. Look at this! No! Quit. Let's try this again. Remain where we are. Not. Two giants. Oh no. I think I know where we are. There's a you have to there's a, like a pair of unique giants up here you have to fight, and I remember one of them's a spellcaster. It's so fucking nasty. I don't even know. Back up. Scimitar, hit him with a weaken. I don't necessarily like knowing what's tentatively coming. I don't want to blow too much magic. But if these are mountain giants, I'm going to need to blow a bunch of magic. Now would be the time for Ela to be like critting these guys. Oh, they're just hill giants. All right. Tell me what to do. Yeah, you are a cat. Useless until you score that crit on a toenail that causes instantaneous death. I will say weakness seems to have thus far been pretty effective. I notice like it doesn't affect them hitting us, but when they hit us, it's always like no penetration, which is nice. Remain here. Yeah, giant creek house after Green's twins. Oh no, alright. Swell. Enchanted blade. It's gold leaf. Can cast armor plate. No. I know somebody in this party can cast fucking armor plate. There it is. It's armor shield. Is that? Oh, that's a single target. There's an AoE party buff that cranks up your armor class. I can't remember what it's called though. That's okay. Oh my god, really? Just sitting here, game. Come on now. Bet you that solo one is a floater. Achilles toe. There you go. Dude, we cross into totally not Germany. Nah, it's just DW Bradley being DW Bradley. The dude has no. This is like the video game equivalent of a Gonzo dungeon from old D&D, where they just like throw everything in the kitchen sink in. Yeah, there was a floater in there. Okay. I just want to save and walk forward. Fee-fi-fo-fum, we smell das blood of human scum. All right, I know one of these guys is a caster and I'll be asked if I know which one it is. So we'll just attack Fritz. Our neighbor's kitchen sink. You go to wash your hands, but it attacks and tries to devour you. Exactly. Let's cast Weaken on Fritz, Goldleaf, Bless, Rove. We have Silence. Like, I know somebody in this party can cast Silence, too. I want to try Conjuration. Actually, I want to get a fire shield going just in case one of these fuck buckets can cast fireball. Let's see what we're up against here. All right, Klaus is swinging a weapon. Scimitar fucks up. Ooh, Scimitar pays for it. Immediately eats a boulder and dies. Good start. Let's try that again. Oh, video games. In here. Yes, let us move forward. Thank you. Conjuration. Wi-Fi monsters when you can get hired help. Yes. Conjuration thus far hasn't seemed to be too bad. The last time I used it, I summoned like a pack of gargoyles or something. They seemed okay. They didn't really do too much, but they tried real hard. So in that case, like, I'm gonna have Ela try sleeping Klaus. Because if we can lock these guys down. Have Chunk trying to poison Fritz. Scimitar, can you cast silence? I know someone in this fucking party can cast silence. I just don't know who it is. All right, so in that case, I'm gonna have you use the Angel's Tongue and Gold Leaf. Beast. Rove. Definitely want that fire shield. Just in case. Hey, we poisoned one of them. Nice. Oh, slow. All right, so that's going to counter our haste. Klaus is the caster. Really? Come on. Why are you maiming my back row? They suck. Hired help is equals meat shields. Like, nothing was attacking them in the last fight. That's a thing. Because, like, yeah, I would love to have meat shields. Hell yes. Everybody, is it Swell that can cast silence? Yeah, it is. All right. Max out that silence on Klaus. Fritz, use the angel's tongue. Gold leaf, haste. I guess we can try a conjuration. See if he doesn't botch it. Oh, we silenced him. Nice. And he fizzled. Wonderful. I love video games. Okay. All right. So let's have everybody keep beating on Fritz. Scimitar. Probably weakening him. Gold leaf. Try hold monster, maybe? I'm sure they're probably immune to hold monster, but I'm gonna try it anyways. Maybe a stink bomb. Unaffected. Rip. Hila doing some good damage. Oh, we got one of them. Nice. The hold held. Man, Hila and Chunk are fucking doing work. Swell's just like sitting there behind his shield and they're just like pulping this dude. Heal off on Scimitar. Hila can go. Chunk can go. Scimitar. Try an energy blast. Level 5, so you don't like accidentally kill yourself. If you treat hired help badly, they should run away. Absolutely. That was a thing in older D&D. You had the good old fashioned morale roll for when shit really hit the fan. We'll just try an energy blast on this guy. These dudes are fucking beefy. All right, I'm gonna keep going. And if Rove is dead for this, Rove is dead for this. I'm gonna see if we can drop these guys. Because thus far, this feels like this fight is... Rove being a corpse notwithstanding going well. Gold leaf, I want you to drop another make wounds. Yes! All right, that's one of them down. These dudes are beefy as hell. I am so glad that hold spell landed on this one. Otherwise, holy shit. This would be nuts. And I think he's silenced too. Don't really have any other buffs we can throw, at least not from Swell. I think it's probably best to just have the front row fight. Scimitar. Magic missile seems okay. I'm gonna throw one more high power make wounds, and then I'm gonna have Goldleaf hold on to the rest of her spell points. So my hope is that this dude isn't as beefy as the other one. Front row's doing good damage. Like all around, actually. Goldleaf just passed out. Back up. Swell? No. Back up. Can you cast stamina? You can. Goldleaf passed out because she ran out of stamina. So I'll have Swell remedy that. While everybody else looks busy. Oh, we got him. Nice. 6k XP, another giant sledge, which isn't really worth anything. Oh, I'm saving. Worth. All right, swell. Where's your swag bag? Remove. Scroll of Resurrection. Use Scroll of Resurrection on the fucking corpse. Damn it, Rove. Now he's missing experience points. Spell? Gold leaf? It's like an anti-magic area or something here. It's not letting me cast spells. Can I cast here? That worries me. What about up here? Why isn't it letting me cast spells? That's very worrying. That's worse, though. Oh my. And Rove sitting in the background like, I regret having tanked the floor. Fight. Scimitar. God, half the party, like everyone is asleep. Scimitar with the loot, maybe? This might be a reload here. Oh, they're going for Rove. I saw it. One of them's unconscious. Throwing rocks at Ela. Whacking Chunk. I'm gonna have to sleep that hill giant. All right, everybody except Rove is awake, naturally. You know, how you would expect it to be. Scimitar. I do love that the loot, like even this late in the game, is still effective. I'd say we're like nearing mid game now, I would say. Okay, Rove is healed. Probably still gonna die if he gets hit, but. Ow. Fuck, those things hit hard. Holy shit. 26 damage. Oh, and Rove is finally deigned to rouse himself from his beauty sleep. Keep trying with that loot. Gold leaf. Need like some big ol' heals here on Scimitar. No, Rove is casting something. I'm gonna try the fireball and hopefully he won't roast my party. Kill one? Kill one? No! Things are so beefy. One's gotta be about dead. The hill giant needs to fucking go to sleep. Okay, there we go. We got one. I just like seeing kills because it means one less thing swinging at me. Okay, everybody on the other one. Old leaf, you don't really have much to do. Rove. I guess just an energy blast. Nice, okay. All right, now it's just a hill giant. Melee should be able to just cut this guy down tentatively. It's uninjured, so it's gonna take a bit, I think, but. This should be in the realm of people to fight here. I'm probably gonna have Rove throw another energy blast. 24 damage, not bad. There we go. This should be good XP too. Yeah, 3,400. I was gonna say levels, yeah. Okay, what do we got? 33, 36 will be another level of spells for Sim. See, he's going to be multi-classing, so I'm actually not going to dump points into his music. Because as a ranger, he won't be able to use his bardic instruments anymore. I guess I'll just dump it into his thaumaturgy then. Not getting another level of spells until 54, but... Oh, we could give Sin Fireball. Ice shield might actually be handy. But fireball. I mean, I can't not, right? We have to take fireball. Okay, 8 points on gold leaf, 58. She gets her next level at 75. Oof. Just dumping them all in. Let's see. Sane mind could be useful. Blades. Conjuration for gold leaf. Silence whirlwind. Pure paralysis. Let me see. What is this? Water magic. Cure paralysis, I'm not too interested in. Paralyze, though. Paralyzes Otzel and paralyzes a single target. That sucks. Alright. What about... Sane Mind is very tempting because Insanity is terrible. I assume Blades is probably just like a basic Earth attack spell. Blades. 2 to 8 damage. Ooh, it's an AoE. Up to 4 enemies, which would be, it would be nice for her to have an offensive spell, but she's going to have like no mana, but I'm going to take it anyways. Because goddamn, Goldleaf needs some offensive punch. I did not mean start another fight, but I'm going to take it. I'm here for your experience points. Goldleaf, cast your wimpy little blade spell. Row of magic missile. We need to sleep pretty badly. I mean, it's damage. The other downside is that, like, when people multi-class, well, I don't know if Goldleaf stats are actually high enough. You get bonus spell points to your casting schools based on your piety. And I think Goldleaf's is high enough right now. I don't care about her leggings. I think Goldleaf's is high enough right now that she's getting a bonus. Yes. If you have a piety of 15 or higher, you get bonus spell points. So they're going to be losing that when they multi-class. Sadly. Okay. Nap. Good lord. The wimpy blade spell deals as much damage as the weapons. I don't know. The melees now are to the point where they're all getting multiple attacks. They're slowly getting a little bit better. Slowly. Oh, these are going to be... These are floaters, I think. Come on, guys. Oh, y'all are fucked. Y'all are fucked because you decided to completely sleep on your first round. Probably because Elo's asleep. I got one of them. Paralyzed. That's great. Good XP, though. Hey, there's Rose level. 4 hit points. I guess just Thaumaturgy. 72, is that a new level? Or is it 74? 75. Ah, so when Rove hits 10th level, he's actually going to get a new level of spells. Although, Prismic Missile. We're getting to the point now where we're getting some of the good ones. Prismic Missile is great. I'm not going to say it's better than Fireball, but Prismic Missile is fun because you can fuck with things. So many spell points, though. Magic Screen. We're getting to the point where we're going to need stuff like that lets us help resist magic. Reduces magic damage and duration, reduced by 1/10 each round. Anti-magic. Random chance for spell failure. Wow, thanks. Blink is tempting. I wish I could get him a damage dealing spell in Earth magic. He might be able to get one as a scion. Earth acid. Yes, he'll be able to learn blades actually as a psionic. Wonderful. Reminds you of going into a candy store. I know, right? I love it. Deep freeze. No spell points though. What is deep freeze? That sounds like that is the highest level water spell. One enemy deals, it looks like 3 to 10 damage per power level, 18 to 60 at highest. And then I think ice ball is just like a fireball, but cold damage. 3 to 12 damage to 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, or 10 enemies. Damage scales up. Let me compare that to a fireball real quick. No, there's fire spells in here somewhere. Fireball. Okay, so ice ball is actually better than fireball. Costs more mana, but it's better. But Rove has no training whatsoever in water magic, so I'm probably going to pass on that. After we level him to 10 in psionic and transfer him back to mage, I'll probably have him start working on water magic. For now, though, I'm just going to lean into the fire spells. Deep freeze and grimoire was broken, though. They patched that. Oh, wait, no. Upresting. Scimitar's just like, yeah, almost dead. Let's not do that, please. Thank you. Now let's save and try again. Okay. Oh, hey, it's more giants. I would have never guessed. All right. I don't know if... You have additional fireballs. He can cast fourth level. Let's watch him roast half my party. It'll be fun. Bless going. Rove is, of course, sleeping. This is what he does. No, it wasn't intentional. Of course it wasn't intentional. Oh, my lord. It wouldn't surprise me with Cleave being completely broken in the head. But no, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure that one wasn't intentional. No, go back. Gold leaf. I guess cast blades. Why not? Rove, let's try out Prismic Missile. We'll just do a third level one and see what it does. 51 damage. 90 damage. Look at that. Prismic Missile's pretty good. It's actually quite uncommon that it just deals damage like that. Normally it's like it drives things insane and stuff. It, for the most part, it just does a lot of status effects. Oh, it's the Guardian of the Rock. Yeah, I am the Guardian of the Rock. Are you here to take it? No. Did you bring an offering also? No. Be gone. All right. Note to self. Guardian of the Rock will be back. I could probably try and fight that thing, but I bet it would kick my shit in. So let's not and say we did. What we got over here? Achtung, press button for DOS exit. Button. It just dumps us out with no way to go back up. All right. I assume the tunnel ends abruptly as apparently there was a cave in some time ago. You might be able to dig through it using the proper tool. Well, we do still have. I love you, Celt. We need to get Ela in here for all of this DOS German. Amazulu zombies. Okay. They didn't want to spring for the titty corpses, so we just get regular zombies. Titties are probably going to have to wait until next stream, sadly. I'm sorry, guys. I know you're thirsty, but that's okay. Actually, back up. Swell, can't you dispel undead? Yes, you can. Nuke these fuckers. Gold leaf, also, get with the nukage. Rove, look pretty. Rove in the back of a party fighting with a fucking bullwhip. Oh, they vomit stinking odors. Oh god, they all vomit stinking odors. It's like our stink bomb spell. Sin's gonna die. Get him. I got two of them. If Goldleaf can get the others. Yes! Esports. 2,000 XP, I'll take it. This appears to be some sort of burial chamber. Wrapped mummies being laid in alcoves cut from the earth. The ground is dirt and clay, and broken pieces of pottery lie scattered about the room. The ghost is saving out of cowardice and healing Scimitar, who probably has like a hit point. Uh-oh. Hey, Swell, you got any? Uh-oh. Chunk, buddy. There you go. There you go, Scimitar. Have a couple hit points. Let's try sleeping. I've triggered the chat. Sin's dying from the stink. Sin will be fine. Hela probably rolling in it. Nothing. Alright. We're sleeping again. I don't know what kind of random encounters we're gonna get in here. I would expect more zombies, but who knows? I would just like to get some mana back. I regret my life choices leading up to this point. Poor Scimitar's asleep. I was gonna have him fireball. But that's okay, Rove's awake. Rove can fireball. Rove can big fireball. Tentatively before they attack. And maybe he won't blow up half the party. Oh yeah. There's something that's just fucking satisfying about lighting a bunch of dead bodies on fire. Wait. Things are good XP. Like an easy 2,000 experience points. How are we looking? I think he levels at 180? 179. A couple more fights like that. This game's just tempting me to keep playing past the end of stream time. So I probably will. Who would have thought sleeping in a mausoleum would attract undead? I don't know. Strange. This area has been chiseled out as if someone were trying to tunnel into the rock for some reason. Investigating it further, you can feel a slight wisp of air seeping through a crack, possibly from another tunnel on the other side. Oh, hey, look. Look, you guys. We've unlocked a shortcut. Is this Dark Souls? Oh, God. I wasn't expecting six zombies. I just fell undead. Melee. Go back, Scimitar. Get with the fuego. Come on now. You know how this works. Rove just cackling like a schoolgirl in the background. Stank souls with all the smell-based spells. Look at that fireball do work. 44 damage. Holy shit. Then Scimitar throws one as well. Such a waste of spell points, but I guess it levels their casting stats, I suppose. See, this is like a really good place to just level, grind our faces off in here. Because now we have access to all of the AoE in the world. Alright, fine. We'll just let everybody melee and Rove can like lob his doom bolts at these things. Here, just 24. We'll see how level 4 one does. It's probably ain't gonna kill them all though. Yeah, this is just gonna soften them up. Now the melees have to actually fucking earn their keep. Grinding commence the spin. Damn right, it's coming. Come on, guys. Come on. I was gonna say, Rove softened these things up enough. This shouldn't be an issue. I was gonna say, like, another fight like that and we're gonna have more levels. I bet these fucking alcoves in the wall, I bet that there are some of them that do have things, like, tucked away in them. I'm gonna get punished for not spending a bunch of time searching all of them. Then the walkthrough will be like, you must have searched everything or you get nothing. Oh, God. All right, who's awake? Swell, Chunk. Oh, Rove, we're good. Rove, burn them. Flailing around with his sword, Swell's like, I'm helping. And then Rove just like waves a hand and all that remains is ash. Rotting corpse touches Ela. Joke's on you, he liked it. All right, this should be levels. Yes. 9 hit points. Damn. Oh, Swell's maxed out his sword skill too. Hell yeah. 50. I think he's going to be a fucking point away, isn't he? Oh no, it's 54 for the next level. I was going to be salty there for a second. Ela gets aroused. God damn it, Ela. Let's see. What does Whirlwind do? I'm sure it's probably an offensive spell that for a non-offensive caster is going to just be absolutely useless. Yeah, it's an AoE damage spell. 1-7 damage per power level and affects 4 enemies plus 1 additional enemy. Actually, I think I'm going to have him get Cure Poison. That'll give us more uses of it in the party. Hey, Ela. God, your thaumaturgy is bad, bro. You're trying. All right, a 20. And Cure Jutsu. So you should get some higher level spells. Poor Ela. Ela just can't cast anything. Ela has a shitbox of a thaumaturgy skill because I have him attack every round instead of cast spells. Because he's one of the... Him and Chunk are like the damage in this party when it comes to like non-spell-based combat. Wow, 2 of them. Man, we're in trouble now. Oh shit. Rove's out of fireballs. We're in trouble now. Swell judging Rove while the latter's just elbow deep in skeletons. It's like... He's like sticking his fist into like the alcoves and just like pulling bones out, throwing them everywhere. Ela still rolling around in the rotting corpses. Yeah, those things, like, they nauseate us, which is kind of irksome, but I think your lesser condition, I think, will remove that. Yeah. Manageable. I'm waiting for the boss fight. All right, we have stairs up. Tunnel is filled with sand, making further travel into it impossible. We need to remember this. Sand. Okay, I want to check. Chung, what are you at? 183, and I think you need 190? 192, all right. So we're going to sit and we're going to grind until Chunk levels, and then we'll call it a stream, I think. The boss will become a vampire. If I recall correctly, what's going on here is that we're in like a burial ground under a temple of these Amazulus, and when we go up it's Amazons, and then we got all kinds of fun stuff to fight depending on how we approach it. Rove. Rove can just look busy, I guess. Hell yeah. Spell Undead doing work. Later on, there's another spell we'll want to get. I think it's called Astral Gate. And it basically functions like Dispel Undead, but it affects like demons and shit. And it makes fighting them a lot easier. But we have, I would say, a very good ways to go before we have to worry about that kind of stuff. Dispel demon, basically, yes, that's basically what it does. Let me check. I think it's called Astral Gate. It's Astral Gate, yeah. Go back, Astral Gate. And it just says like kills demons. Alright, good talk. You cast that by putting I mean that's one way to cause some astral related chicanery, to be sure. Probably not the kind that most folks want to deal with, though. All right, let's get some heals out here. And then we have some mana. Heal Ela. God damn it. Spell, swell, heal, sin. There we go. Save, and now we spin. Oh, that was fast. It's like they don't get any health. They get health back, it's just that these bars have like basically five states to them, maybe. So it's hard to tell. Because, you know, 20% of your hit points might be 20 hit points for like, well, for swell, it'd be like 16. And you don't heal that much. Most of your healing comes from the curative magic. Man, Ela, why can't you cast Fireball? Theoretically, once he's got enough levels under his belt, Ela will be able to cast Fireball, I think. So we'll have half this party capable of casting Fireball. This makes me happy. It's how nature should be. It's healing. Okay. We didn't measure things by pixels back in the day. True. Yeah, the jars are like... The bars, rather, are more like rough estimates of maybe what your hit points are, you know, if you're lucky. People are retching because they're nauseous, spells aren't going off. Damn it, guys. Oh, fizzled on his fireball. God damn it. Sin. Not mad, just disappointed. Okay. Then Rove immediately, like, backblasts the party with it. The Cult of Fwoosh, hell yeah. Always like your hard numbers, hell yes. Yes, absolutely. I would always prefer numbers over bars. Chunk punches a rotting corpse so hard it explodes. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. There we go. This is not an unreasonable spot to grind. The downside, though, is that, like, these next levels are gonna be fucking hell. It's like, Swell goes from needing 179,000 to 358,000. Oh, it hurts so fucking bad. 9 to 10 is gonna be, like, next session, like, we're probably not gonna be doing any grinding. I don't expect to grind for levels next session. We're just going to be pushing as hard as we can to get done with things. Could it fit here? Numbers over bars? Probably, but you'd be missing some things, I think. Or, I mean, like, where they have, like, the class name and the OK symbol there, you could have, like, your HP... And then, like, just remove the class name, I guess? Have just H, or just H, or just a number. But it would be tight and probably funky looking, but I don't think it'd be any worse looking than having, you know, Lore, Nin, Pri, and Sam on the side of the screen. There we go. More nap. Nothing wrong with off-screen grinding. Oh, there's nothing wrong with it, but I'm not gonna do it. Oh no, this is a playthrough. Everybody gets to see everything. It's part of the fun. Because I mean, if I like wanted to that bad, I could just like cheat my stats and not have to worry about it. Like, oh yeah, I spent 12 hours grinding on these things and now everybody's like been leveled 1 to 1040 times. Nah, I'll make y'all suffer. Monrove, nuke them all, please. Shared grinding is doubled grinding. Like, that's the other thing is that, like, if I had to grind this on my own, I probably realistically just wouldn't do it. Yeah, I have better things to do with my time. But I will make all of you wait. Hey, save, rest. Oh, this is not a good one. I mean, we're okay because Rove is active and he can just fireball them all, but Oh, so much damage. We gotta be getting close. There we go. 9 hit points. Hell yeah. Good roll. Oh, let's see. Alchemy 1. Oof. How is his alchemy still 1? I've been casting spells with him not infrequently. Chunk, being a lazy ass, man. Itching skin. Okay. Let's see. What do I want to do? I want to get us out of here. I'm gonna save. I'm gonna get us down to the mana fountain. That way I can just heal everybody. And let's see. Man, I am so thankful for this freaking mini-map mod, though. Good God. Just puttering through this. Like, I have a pretty good spatial awareness. But this mine would break me. Like, there is no way I would be able to navigate this mine. Get off here by hurling myself off of the mountain. I mean, we've already done it half a dozen times. Well, that's the other thing, is that, like, to me, part of streaming is just, like, hanging out and, you know, chilling out and bullshitting with people. And it makes the grind less terrible. And like when we're grinding or when I'm like wandering around completely lost, like that's when we're having our conversations about like, you know, old D&D and weird shit like that. And so I feel less bad about it. Fucking skeletons. Ela still nauseated from rolling around in the corpse meat. Can't stand labyrinth games. I don't mind them so long as I've got a mini map. If I've got to like map it on my own or whatever, it's a shit show. Cause like I understand that like part of old dungeon crawlers like this is it being like a big dungeon. Like I'm okay with that. But when they get like purposefully really bad, but yeah, it's just hanging out. And that's the other thing is that since I'm a smaller streamer, it's like hanging out with a bunch of people that I know. So it's like hanging out and playing video games with friends. And I can get behind that. All right, let's get back over there. Going the wrong way. Oh, hey, it's more victims. Hi, guys. Sin. Loot. I'll ideally use as little magic on these guys as I can. Get some stuff for your Pathfinder group. Did you give them some strange contraption requiring a rubber band to fuck about with? Wizardry Labyrinth of Lost Souls has such bland dungeons. Like, that's the other thing, is like when it's all just like a bunch of copy-paste hallways, that's also kinda horrifically painful. That's actually one thing I have to give Demise. Like, that game is literally nothing but run around in this huge labyrinthine dungeon, murdering things to make your numbers get bigger. Like, there is next to no meaningful plot in that game. But the environment design in it is, like, there's always something nifty to look at. And that's hard. And it's something that this game actually kind of fails at, because everything looks the same. They blew their budget on the monster sprites. Ooh, we found a katana. Ela, you can take that. I wonder, did Ela just get an upgrade? I don't know if he can dual wield katanas. No. Ah, disappointing. Ela got nothing. Ela's a disappointment. Such a shame. How can he not wear leather boots? Why? Good Lord. Alright, swag bag, steel helm, swag bag, leather boots. He's got equipment waiting for him when he turns into a fighter, though, at least. I do have a pair of fur leggings. I want to actually give those to Ela. Because, yeah, like, Ela's going to have an entire, like, gear set waiting for him. Because, yeah, fighters can use them. Nice. And then I'll just stuff all of his samurai stuff into his swag bag, because that's all that's in there is just gear swaps for class alternates. You're not Zoro, I'm sorry. Ow. Sadly, you cannot dual wield katanas and like cut tanks in half with them. One in each hand, one in the mouth. Oh my god, Zoro. I missed that. He says Zoro, and I'm like, ah, the mask of Zoro. No, it's fucking weeb trash, and he's talking about One Piece. Boo! Ela disowned. Okay. There we go. We have made it. I have survived. And I think on that note, I am going to go ahead and call it a stream here.